Hello everyone. Today I'm gonna represent a paper. Name is MobiCode, which is a mobile-friendly hand mouse reconstruction from monocular images. And it was published in CBPL 2022. And as the title suggests, this paper focuses on accuracy, computational efficiency, and also the temporal consistency. So first, let me introduce the hand mouse estimation method. And in terms of hand mouse estimation methods, it can be divided into five types. The first type is the mano-based model. So typically, they use the mano as the parametric model. And this mano model take the shape and pose parameter as input and output the 3D mesh. However, this method may not suitable for usage with a lightweight network. And secondly, this is a Voxel representation which describes 3D data in a 2.5D manner. And this method is also not friendly for memory constrained mobile devices. And thirdly, the method that based on implicit functions. So it has various of continuity and high resolution. And usually they use for digitizing quantitative children. And this method may need a lot of computation of 3D points. So it may lack efficiency in mobile setting. And another method that rely on UV map. So this kind of method, they used for image-to-image translation tests that connect 2D to 3D spaces. And the last step of the hand-mouse reconstruction method, which rely on vertex position. So this method directly predicts 3D vertex coordinates, and they usually follow a procedure of 2D encoding, 2D to 3D mapping, and finally, they use 3D decoding to produce the final mesh. So the motivation of this paper is that in the previous state of the art methods, they focus only the accuracy, but require high computational cost, or they focus on the computation efficiency, but less accuracy. So to solve this problem, in this paper, they propose MobiCon, which is a mobile-friendly hand-mesh reconstruction, which can provide accuracy and also focus on computational efficiency and temporal coherence. So in this network, it contains only 123 million multiple and additional operations and only 5 million number of parameters. And it can achieve 83 frames per second running on Apple A14 on CPU. And it is a small number of parameters and computational cost is right and also fast. So let me go to the architecture of the MobiCon. And in this architecture, it consists of three modules, start from the 2D encoding, 3D decoding to produce the 3D mesh, and between the 2D encoding to 3D decoding, they require feature lifting module to map the 2D output to the 3D mesh. So in 2D encoding here, they use a convolutional network to extract the feature map. And in the lifting feature here, to map the 2 to 3D space, they use a map regression followed by pose pooling to retrieve pose aligned features. Then they follow the PBL to obtain the feature in 3D space. And they use the DS convolution with upsampling to produce the final mesh. And I will detail one by one in the next slide. So first, it comes from the 2D encoding. And in this paper, they try to design the lightweight network to produce the feature map. And in the 2D encoding here, they design two lightweight outcross structures to express the image. And first, they investigate using the landscape structure, which consists of only 373 million multiple additional operations, which consists only 6 million number of parameters. And secondly, they use ghost state, which consists of 96 million multiple and additional operations, and with 5 million number of parameters. And the first is the dense block, and the last block here, it is the ghost state block. And in the 2D encoding here, they follow the state structure. So first, they use the block, whether dense state or ghost state. And then they upsample the first block in order to fit the final feature map into the first layer of the second block here. And after that, they stack the second block here onto the first block to get the final feature map. And in the right table here, it just demonstrates the accuracy or error when they use different 2D encoding here. And you can see here, like ghost state, it has the less number of parameter, but in terms of the error is higher than using dense state here. And they also investigate whether they train from scratch or whether they train using the pre-trained model on ImageNet or using the pre-trained model from the complementary data that they have. And secondly, to map the 2D to 3D mapping, they use the lifting feature. And the first speaker here, it demonstrates the traditional method that they do not have the feature lifting module. They use only a fully connected operation to map the global feature of the image into the 3D space. But in the Mobricon, they have a lifting feature which divided into three steps. So first they predict, they estimate the 2D key point, and after that they extract the key point feature, and finally they map those key point feature into the 3D space, as you can see in the middle figure here. So in terms of the 2 to 3 mapping, they also investigate 2D post-estimation method, like they when method rely on heat map regression, or the method they rely both heat map and regression. So when the method rely on heat map, they can produce high resolution expression, but the receptor field is too small, as you can see in the figure A here. And in the figure B, in the figure C here, which means that the method that rely on regression. So in the regression, it can produce the low resolution and receptive field. So the shallow features and loss and the ability to express the detail is not sufficient. And there are some methods that combine heat map and regression together. Then they can call it as heat map plus of F max, as you can see the figure B here. It is the heat map and regression. So in this method, it can take the advantage of heat map to produce high resolution, but none of them cannot investigate the spatial structure and the spatial structure of the final output. So in this paper, they propose a map-based position regression, or we can call it as map regression, as we can see in the figure D here, to produce medium resolution expression, and also it has symmetric global receptive field. So to do that, they propose a very small four-time upsampling network with shallow feature in processing upsampling. So this is the 2D spatial structure. And then they expand the 2D spatial structure into 1D vector. And after that, they use MLP to express 1D vector into 2D coordinate of multiple key points. And let me go to tonight. And this is just the visualization, but the method use heat map regression or map regression proposed in MobiCon. So I think you can see the blue dot here. It is the blue dot. The blue dot here indicates the predicted key point. So in the first row, it is the method that rely on heat map. And in heat map, it just focus on individual landmark. And there is no inter-point interaction. And in the second row, it is the method that rely on soft arc map. So it is just the smooth or sharp version of heat map. And in the last row, it is the map regression proposed in this paper. So in the map regression, it can describe the relation among the landmarks. And we can see like the highlight here, it is like the relation in the key point in each finger. So after the map regression, we can get the feature vector of each landmark. And after getting the feature vector, they need to map them into the 3D space. So in order to map them, they propose pose to vertex lifting, and we can call it as PVL for the short form of this. And in this PVL, it is a like simplification version of GCN, and they like the modified GCN network. As we know that GCN to obtain the feature, the 3D, the to obtain the 3D feature, they require to use this formulation. And in this formulation, it require adjacency matrix A, and D is the degree matrix. And for this operation, it is used to propagate and transformation the feature vertices across the node in the graph. And from this to this, it is used to smooth the feature vector. But in PVL proposed in MobiCon, they extremely simplify GCN. So they set A and D to constant. And it requires only the learnable metric M and the landmark feature that we can obtain from map regression in the previous slide. And this is just the figure shown in the PVL feature. It is the landmark feature here. And M is the learnable metric, M frame. And in order to reduce the computational cost in M here, they downsample 4 times and they upsample them in the 3D decoding. And in the below figure here, it shows the highly correlated feature propagation between the key point here and mesh vertices in the right image here. And this is like the computation complexity when used in PVL. And in this slide, it demonstrates the visualization of PVL. So this figure here, it is shown the alert metric in a lifting metric. And in the column, in the direction of the row here, it is the index of key point. And the direction in the column here, it is the index of the vertices. And we can see that PVL is sparse because most of the position are close to zero. And PVL also has global representation. As we can see in the joint number 5 here, it contributes to each mesh vertex of geometry. And also, PBL also symmetric coherence, symmetric consistency. And in the below table here, it demonstrates the feature lifting module. And in the first row here, it is the setting of the CMO, which is another paper published in CBPO 2021. And when this network use map regression, landmark with map regression, the 2D and 3D accuracy is higher than use regression or heat map or the baseline. And in terms of the smoothness, it also better than the previous method. It also when using the regression and heat maps method based. And finally, it comes to the 3D decoding, which is module is used to predict the final match. And in this paper, they propose to use depth supportable spiral convolution network, which is lightweight. And in this network, they progressively choose the point level feature in the point y and depth y direction. And as we can see in the right table here, when they use the DS convolution and another convolutional network in order to produce the 3D mesh, we can see that DS convolution outperform faster than the spiral convolutional network. And now it goes to the log function. In this paper, in order to provide high accuracy in terms of 3D mesh, they has the accuracy. In terms of accuracy loss, they use L1 normalization for 3D mesh and 2D pulse between the prediction and ground truth B step. And also, they adopted the normalization loss and edge loss in order to smooth the 3D mesh. And see here, it is the face of the mesh. And MC star here indicates the unit node monitor of the face. And star, it is the ground truth. And also, they use the consistency loss based on the data augmentation without temporal data. So to do that, there are two views from the there are two views that can be derived from an image sample. Based on the 2D affine transformation and color shifter. So or from view one to view two, it is the relative rotation of the 2D affine transformation between two views and rotation and T, it is the translation, it is the relative translation between view one and two view two, and it is like the log function used in order to calculate the consistency loss in 3D space, and this below here it is the 2D space. And finally, the overall loss function can be defined by summation of the 3D mesh, 2D pulse, normalization, and edge here, and consistency loss 2D and for 3D loss. And this is the result. They train on the freehand, and they use the freehand evaluation and compare them to the previous method. And the first second here, when they use the goal state and gain state, and state indicate that they follow the state structure. And we can see it is the lightweight, but can provide high accuracy. And for fair comparison, they also use ResNet 18 and ResNet 50, and they also follow the state structure. And we can see that the final ResNet 50 here, it has 5.7 in terms of the showing error, and also in terms of the accuracy error. It can outperform the previous method, but it's close, but yeah, this one is better. And for the And for the design here, it means that the model are totally unrelated to the complement data. And for this sign here indicate that the model use their complementary data to train with their freehand data and evaluate on freehand data set. And in the second table here, it indicates the result when they evaluate on HO3D version 2 data set. And in terms of HO3D data set, they use only GoldStake and DanceTech as a backbone. And we can see that only use DanceTech as a backbone, the join are less than the previous method. And in terms of the mesh accuracy, it also higher than the previous method. And they also evaluate on OHV data set. And we can see that Mobicon provide the best result on OHV data set compared to the previous methods. And finally, it is the qualitative result. They also record a snippet video in order to demonstrate the temporal coherence and articulated structures. And this video, they use the static camera and static hand in order to reduce the low acceleration. And we can see like this figure here, it shows the 2D post acceleration consistency. And we can see the red color here indicate the Mobicon, and the blue or green indicate the other method. And in terms of the 2D post acceleration consistency, the Mobicon is better. And in the 3D post and also the brute recovery acceleration, also Mobicon is the better result. And this is the 2D post from CMO, and we can see that each point of the key point is not accurate yet. But in the Mobicon, each point of the key point, like here, the Mobicon provides the better result if compared to the CMO. Yeah, that's all for me in the presentation.
So actually, seeing is optimizing process to make only using the transformer similar to the